If dropping your lap times at the racetrack for free sounds too good to be true, keep watching because we're going to find out how that's possible. Many track day enthusiasts will take their car to the racetrack, giving no consideration to their tyre pressures and often running the same tyre pressure on the racetrack that they run on the street. Correctly setting your tyre pressure can improve the contact patch between the tyre and the racetrack, improving grip and hence reducing your lap times, as well as making your car feel more balanced and enjoyable to drive. In this test, we're going to have a look at exactly what the effect of tyre pressure is on the tyres using a Nitto NT01 semi-slick on our Nissan 350Z. The Nitto NT01 is a common and popular tyre for the track day enthusiast market. What we're going to do is start by setting our cold tyre pressure to 35 psi. Now, while this is possibly a little higher than we'd normally run on the street, this higher tyre pressure is going to accentuate the effect of a tyre pressure that's too high out on the racetrack. Let's head out onto the track now and we'll see what the tyre pressure does and we'll analyse how the car performs. So we're out on the track now with our initial high tyre pressures, and what we find is that straight away, right from leaving the pits, the car's really easy to drive. The car points and turns into corners really well and it's really quite stable. What we do find though is that the car doesn't have a huge amount of grip in some of the low speed corners where it's naturally a little bit traction limited, so we find that the car can be a little bit skaty coming out of those corners. It means that we have to be a little bit careful with our throttle application to make sure that we don't lose grip, lose traction. The more important thing to note though when we are running these high tyre pressures is that after the car has performed 2-3 hard laps and we're starting to build a lot more temperature into the tyre, this naturally also increases the amount of pressure that's in the tyre. And under these conditions, this is where we start to notice that the grip levels can really go away, and the car again in the low speed corners can become quite skating. We get a little bit out of shape just like that. Let's head back into the pits now and we'll have a look at the data. When we come back into the pits, the first thing we can do is check our tyre pressures, and we can see that the tyre pressures have increased to approximately 42 to 45 psi. Now remember, when we headed out with the tyres cold, we'd set our tyre pressures to 35 psi, and this increase is as a result of the temperature that we've built into the tyre as we've been driving around the track. Now, with those higher tyre pressures, the effect that we see is that the tyre tends to balloon out, and rather than the entire contact patch or width of the tyre contacting the track, we end up predominantly with the centre of the tyre contacting the track. Now, in order to demonstrate this effect, we've fitted the car with 3 infrared tyre temp sensors from Texense on each corner of the car. These tyre temp sensors monitor the inside edge, the centre and the outside edge of the tyre while the car is running around the track, and all of this data is logged onto a MoTeC C125 Dash logger. Let's have a look at that data now and see what we can find. We're viewing the data here in MoTeC's I2 analysis software, and this breaks the tyre temperatures up graphically so it's really easy to see what's going on. At the top here we have the temperatures representing the outside edge of the tyre, then we've got the temperatures from the centre of the tyre, and finally we've got the temperatures from the inside edge. And we're just looking at one tyre here and we're looking at one part of the track. We're looking at just coming up to the exit of the southern loop here at Highlands Motorsport Park, and the important point to take away is that we see that relatively consistently the centre of the tyre is hotter than both the inside and the outside edge, and that's that effect of the higher tyre pressures being shown in the data. So the takeaway for you at home, if you're taking your car to track days, is that for just the small investment in a tyre pressure gauge, or even borrowing one from a mate at the track and monitoring and setting your tyre pressures, you can improve and reduce your lap times. Now, if you don't know where to start with your tyre pressures, we've found that for a semi-slick such as our Nitto NT01, on a moderate weight car such as our Nissan 350Z, a tyre pressure of approximately 32 psi hot is a pretty good place to start. So I'd suggest that you begin there and then make adjustments both up and down in 2 psi increments before heading out on the track and testing to see what the effect of that change is.